Well, whether it's a contribution to the arts, to a charity, or even a local school, South Dakota communities often come together to support worthy causes. That's true in southeast South Dakota in the town of Freeman, where an annual celebration of shared heritage and food has been going strong for more than a half century.
If you are ever lucky enough to be in Freeman and you can go to the big Schmeckfest supper, get there early and plan to stay a while, don't worry, you won't have any trouble getting a place at a table. And they're not going to run out of food. Nope, that's not going to happen. It's just that there's a lot to do here, even before you sit down to eat. But wait, what is that word, Schmeck?
Okay, in German, it's a German word. Schmeck is the sense of taste and of smell. And fest is basically festival. So it'll be a festival of celebrating the sense of taste and smell.
From the spicy scent of frying sausages to the light sweet aroma of baked treats of all sorts, this place smells great. Tastes even better.
I am making Schuckenkröpfle or cottage cheese pockets. First they're boiled and then we brown them and fry them up over there.
During the afternoon, they make the sausage that they'll serve at the evening supper. A lot of it is also sold and bought for take home.
Well, we purchased 11,000 pounds of meat and the meal uses about 1,100. And we hope to sell the other 10,000 here.
Rensink is also a pork producer, so now you know where the meat comes from. They recently started using a big commercial mixer, but at least for the demonstrations, the sausage is made by hand.
Well, it's kind of the old-fashioned way. We use the old hand-crank stuffers, and that's a little more work.
It might be old-fashioned, but Schmeckfest is completely modern in the sense that all of the food is prepared and presented in accordance with strict food safety guidelines. Nothing is made at home. From the roll served at dinner to the much-loved Kuchen dessert available for take-home, everything is produced in Freeman Academy's commercial-grade facilities.
Obviously, when you're dealing with food and with that many people and that large of a quantity of food, safety is a major concern of ours. And there are some things that we've done over the years that have helped make it a very safe environment for people to come and enjoy the meal. And some of those things are, we are inspected by state inspectors, the sausage making, there are meat inspectors that come out, and so we go through that process very thoroughly. And they're always providing suggestions that we can continue to do to make it a good environment for our guests.
While people browse the booths and samples, hard work is underway in the kitchen. On Friday and Saturday nights, on two consecutive spring weekends, this volunteer crew will prepare and serve a family-style supper for 1,000 diners.
1,000 people each night, so 4,000 total. Our meal consists of noodle soup, green bean soup, then stewed beef, homemade pork sausage, smoked, fried potatoes, knepfle, which is a little German macaroni with a little cottage cheese, a lettuce salad with the sour cream dressing, sauerkraut, Huttrich style, which is a sweet sauerkraut, and then for dessert there's Plumemousse, which is a creamy pudding kind of thing with dried fruit, and Kuchen, the South Dakota state dessert, and poppy seed roll.
These days it all runs like clockwork, but the first Schmeckfest held more than 50 years ago didn't go quite as smoothly.
My grandmother was in the executive committee that originated the first Schmeckfest, which was just to be a very small community affair.
In 1959, the Ladies Auxiliary decided, let's have a Mennonite smorgasbord and we'll charge a dollar admission. And we're going to have a fundraiser that way. Well, they didn't know how many people to prepare for.
Well, they planned for 200 people. And then they got, people started getting excited about it, so they thought, well, we better plan for 400. They aren't really sure, but they think they served close to 1,000 people that first night.
As the evening went along, they were absolutely, totally out of ethnic foods. They were out of foods in general. They went uptown and from Lobber Meat Market bought all the sausage they could find. They went to K&K store and brought all the bread they could find just to make sandwiches, anything that could be served. Finally, they just had to say, we are done. We are finished. We have no more food. People, the door is going to be closed. We're done. We don't have any more. People left the line and went uptown to eat at the restaurants. The restaurants closed early because they ran out of food.
It was a bigger celebration than what they had anticipated. Many people came from a distance that they didn't anticipate.
It's one of the stories now we look back at it and we can laugh about it, but it was no laughing matter for those poor ladies in the kitchen.
They were ready to quit, but they didn't, maybe because of that higher calling of doing something good and important for the school.
Freeman Academy is a school that was started a little over 100 years ago by some of the Mennonites that moved to this area.
Their history can't and shouldn't be told quickly, but at least in terms of ethnicity, their ancestors were Northern or Low Germans, Swiss, and Hutterish, people from within and around Austria. Protestants who left their homelands in the 1700s and 1800s looking for greater religious tolerance in Russia. They didn't find it. In the 1870s, many came here.
And so you often hear about the German-Russian heritage because a lot of the traditions that were picked up came from both countries.
Epp counts a love of music and fine arts among those traditions. It's on full display at Schmeckfest. For years, they've offered evening performances featuring young talent from the academy and more established performers from around the area. Like Schmeckfest itself, the shows have gotten bigger. For 2012, the stage version of The Wizard of Oz.
You know, Schmeckfest started in 1959, and, you know, back then, that was long before my time, but people decided early on that, okay, so you're going to feed them a great meal, now we need to have some entertainment. And in the early years, that entertainment was often in the form of talent shows, people from the community perhaps singing songs or maybe doing some dialogue of some sort. It certainly wasn't to the extent that we have now. When it's all said and done, you're looking at probably 200 people involved in this show. It's really a community-wide celebration. All walks of life, young and old, businessmen, farmers, entrepreneurs, you name it, they're involved. The common denominator is Freeman. There's a tremendous sense of community pride here, and that's really what it's all about. It's all about celebrating being a people together, a community together. That's why this works.
A good show, a good meal, a good cause, and a really good chance that Schmeckfest will be held again next year.
If you'd like to go to the Schmeckfest supper, better plan ahead. Meal and reserve seat show tickets have to be purchased in advance.